Hello, hello, and welcome. I'm Denise. I have made some other videos in the past, and basically what we're going to be using are some, I guess I call them the die-cut flowers. I'm not sure exactly who they're from, but are made by. Anyways, I've been making flowers, as you can see. When I've gotten these, I've been using them for quite some time now. I've been working with the smaller ones and making this, you know, miniature roses for my card projects or, you know, for my shadow box and whatever else projects. And then this size here, I mean, there's some very, very small ones for like your buds, your rose buds in the middle, the center of your flower. And then this is like the biggest size I like to use my flower. I don't like going too big. I actually have here a rose that I bought, but never did I imagine that it would be so big. I'm going to show you as I get through my... Here it is. And this is humongous, okay? And I mean, it's ridiculous large. I mean, it's good for big projects. I mean, that's why I still have it. I did not know this. I should have read. But like I said, it's good to have on hand for one of those big project craft projects that you're making. So that's a humongous rose. Idea I have, and this video is about. I actually been making. I don't know what you want to call it, but to me they're sort of like scrapbook pages, I guess. I don't know. I'm not a big fan of them myself personally, but I've been actually working on tags, and I make them and I just hand them out to my sister because the littlest things that make my family happy. We just, of course, I'm sure many of you crafters are this way. You know, everything that we get, we appreciate and we treasure. Even, you know, just paper products, and they're decorated and we hang them up. Mine I just don't throw out, I keep away and put up and hand them out. So anyways, I've been working on this here, and I've made some flowers, as you can see, that are on this scrapbook page. And if you can see here, this flower on the bottom is done a different than the other ones. The other ones are just basic roses. And I'm gonna, excuse me, I'm gonna show you how I got that effect. Using the bigger sizes of your, goodness, I went ahead already and, like I said, some of these are very big, but perfect for what we're going to be doing. Because when you cut out your smaller pieces, these are just good for the basic center of them, but we're not going to be using these today. So we're going to be using, I'm going to say, 1, 2, 3, 4, we're going to be using probably 4 to 5, okay? There's 5 different sizes here, and it depends on, you know, the biggest size of your flower. And I'm going to actually show you, I have already went ahead and I cut out my flower pieces. Oopsie daisy, it dropped one. And I'm going to show you how we do this. Now, this can be dangerous, and it cannot be. If you have a nail filing gun, actually this would be good to use that for. Very perfect. But I like to use my Demerol. So, it's up to you what you want to do. To me, my Demerol works a lot quicker, and I get sort of a different effect with this craft project than I would using my nail filer. You can actually use just any kind of a filer. You know, it's you're just basically just, I guess, fringing and distressing the edges of your card. Only thing I'm going to show you and I'm going to be doing is a few different ways that I use my Demerol to get... more of the, I guess, the frayed, if that's what you'd call it, fringe look, as you can see on the sides of my paper. I do this, and it makes it a little more of a curly effect rather than just a torn and ripped and distressed. So, here we go. Now, course I get the centers and I get these little hole pieces everywhere in my craft room, but I cut out two at a time, if not three, depending, you know, how many flowers I have in mind. So we're going to take your flower, and we're going to just go ahead and continue our tutorial. And you're going to cut maybe like halfway in towards the circle, around every line, okay? So I'm going to go halfway in, like so. I'm just hoping that you can see what it is I'm doing. Okay, I'm just continuing, I'm extending the cut. Okay, so now what you're going to do, sometimes I find this easier too. If you take every other petal and you fold it back, if you can, if you can't, just the way that they are, they're so big, as you go around, you know, pull that one up and then pull that one back. You know, if you go ahead and do this ahead of time, it helps when you're using your file or your Demerol. So now it's going to get loud, so I'm going to not talk, of course, because I don't want to try to over-talk the Demerol sanding machine, but what you're going to be doing, trying to get as closest to the edge as possible, okay, inside, and going all the way around the whole entire flower petal, okay, and then you're going to do this all the way around. So if I have enough time, because we're limited here on YouTube, and I'm going to try to move as quick as I can because I have not done one ahead of time, which I should, and I'm going to show you what it is I'm exactly talking about, okay? So bear with me for 1 minute. I'm pushing inward and I'm going around, working in a circular motion. Wonderful. Sorry about that. Took a little longer than I expected. But anywho, this is what we have. Okay. You really don't, I mean, there's a couple of things you have to do afterwards to kind of get the effect that we want. But anyways, the reason why we went ahead and not only continued the cut into the flower is two reasons. Because we want this center piece here to kind of to fold up just like you would do the center of the bud, actually. I went ahead and I did do the center already with the smaller pieces. This is just a bigger piece so I can demonstrate to you on how to get this flower. But here you go. Okay, so that's what you have. I mean, it's beautiful. I mean, I love it. Something different. So what I've done was, if you have your rounded ballpoint tool, you can go ahead and you know, just go ahead and center in, or press down in the center to kind of get that rounded effect. And then you could take anything, actually. You could take a, actually I'm using just a plain old paintbrush. You take each petal, and I'm going to stand up while I do this, and you're going to start going towards one of the sides of the petals, and just rounding it. Around, you know, each one of them all the way around. Doo-dee-doo. Okay, and you're going to keep doing this all the way around. Doo-dee-doo. My daughter is, oh, she is going to be a rock star when she gets older. She plays the drums and she just loves her music. When I was, actually her dad is a drum player, but when I was younger, I was raised listening to 50s and 60s music. I'm kind of glad that my parents were the way they were in some ways, but because I do listen to it myself, and so when I do, I explain to my children, which they know now more about music than they did when they're younger, that music not only is an inspirational, especially then, than it is today, there's a story to every song, and a song is sung telling a story. And so they listen to the words and I tell them, but unlike the music today, and I mean no disrespect to anybody, but to certain type of music that I don't condone my children to listen to, sets off negative messages. And so that automatically is not allowed. And as far as I'm concerned, I also tell them that it's uneducational and there's nothing in there that's positive, and there's nothing that they should be listening to. It's no interest whatsoever. Now, if you listen to a song by Otis Redding or Sam Cooke, let's see, I mean, just basically any of the music back in the earlier times, like I said, the 40s, 50s, 60s, and I'm only 39 years old, so it definitely was after my time, you know, my mother and father's music, but I was born in 73. So if I play a song, and which they're used to hearing the type of music that I was raised on, and they notice even till today that there's a lot of songs that are remade of some of the songs from back in the 50s and 60s. So, and does send good messages, and it tells a wonderful story, more sad and some happy. But anyways, so I try to teach her that and to work on her voice. I'm no professional, but I'm a mother, so, yeah, right, Mom? So it's one of our jobs is try to do our best. So anyways, back to our tutorial. I'm sorry, but to drift away from our project. So I'm hoping that this is going to be small enough for this. So then what you're going to do is you're going to take your centerpiece, or your piece, actually I'm going to call it center, and you're going to, just like you would your rose, basically, and you're going to put a little glue on the bottom, or hold it there, and then you go around, apply your little glue around, you know, each petal as you're working around, what you want to do is the opposite sides, okay, do those first, and hold those in, and you don't want to, like, squeeze them on really tight, you know, just really loose, let them dry for a couple of seconds, and then maybe a minute or so, then go to the other opposite two sides, and do the same. Now, I'm noticing that this might be a little bit big, only because it, not necessarily, because it overlaps a little bit, but that's okay, because that's where your Demerol can come in, and you can actually take your Demerol gun and go down and sand down more of your edges. So